different areas of Atlantic and Pacific Oceans, they are stopped from mixing together by means of this Panama. And this Panama is only nothing but the tectonic plate shifting or collision between the North American and South American plates. So these North and South American plates collide before 3 million years, and that collision has resulted in the formation of this Panama, which has resulted in preventing or stopping the meeting and mixture of the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. So such a drastic changes are happening now. Even though if a change could commence now, we are not going to see the impact after a few million years. But now we are here to see the consequence of that which has been commenced before millions of years. So we must understand, not only as an experiencer of something that happened in an antediluvian society, anti-inhabited society or pre-inhabited society, as well as we are going to leave the experience if not properly inhabited. So a lot of things we cannot avoid. There is one theory which is known as evasion theory. There is escapism theory. If there is a mega incident that is going to happen, immediately we cannot stop that. If there is a very big earthquake, we can just reduce to some level, and we cannot say that every disaster of the global thing that can be prevented. We can minimize the loss of lives. We can minimize loss of properties. So we are not going to change the changes which are very natural and inherent to their development mechanics, but we are going to see that we are safe and secure, and we are trying to minimize the loss and try to prevent some human contributions or some human intrusions which has causated or which has added to the causative factors for these drifting and changes. Already they have discussed about volcanoes. Volcanoes, they release lot of dust particles which are known as absorbers. They believe that these absorbers, they absorb more of solar heat, and they are not properly repatriating it, and thereby producing the chill or cool systems in the society. Now recently, scientists, they have understood that whatever the dust particles that are emanated at the time of volcanic eruption, those particles, they absorb and return heat also, and after few months or 1 year, they are resettled in the same earth surface. And this type of volcanic eruption and this contribution is found out to be 130 times more than the impact of other global warming and climate change factors. And the third thing is about solar variability. There is one theory known as a fading young sun paradox. In solar physics, there is a theory. It is known as fading young sun paradox. At first, before now, we are seeing this sun, who is very brighter and red hot and excruciating with its radiation all of us. There was a sun before several millions or trillions of years where he was insufficient or unable to provide proper rain to the surface of the earth because of his thermal insufficiency, because of his negligible thermal infusion and fission. He was unable to make this evaporation process and to retain the cloud particles, and also make by the process of condensation to create rain. So we had such a sun before several trillions of years. As per the rule of fading young sun paradox, that the sun was unable to produce sufficient energy. Now the sun is growing brighter. It is accepted that the sun is growing brighter than before. So this solar variation, how we are going to avoid? It is a natural, which is a heliobasic or a heliocentric theory, that he is growing brighter. What we can do that? According to Sandhyavandana and Surya Upasana, there is a lot of mitigation. I think those things are philosophical and religious. How it can be brought to a common platform, and how it can be induced in the minds of all people. Rationalists, skeptics, scientists, technicians, everybody, they cannot adopt Surya Upasana, Sandhyavandana, Surya Namaskara and Arjya. So common factor is not possible. So there are two ways. One is a preventable. Second thing is not preventable. So science or religion, it gives you the idea of prevention to preventable areas, and how to face or how to develop a courage of survival or minimization or risk reduction in unpreventable areas. This is real prudence. This is real wisdom. It is not just considering everything, just as if you think that you can change everything, that is idiotic. If you think that nothing can be changed, that is lunatic, the person is. So we must understand the difference between preventability and unpreventability. So this is the position of the solar area, and I have told about volcanoes. Then coming to the concluding section, I have to say about the human contribution. Number one, land use by means of agriculture, irrigation and other things. Second thing is afforestation, which is happening now. Like people are growing bald heads, they are also interested in making the earth to resemble their shining heads. Number one is land use. Second thing is afforestation. Third thing is the very famous combustion of fossil fuels. Number fourth thing is aerosols. Aerosols are the particles that particulate matter in the atmosphere. They are known as aerosols. For example, now we are competing with the sulfur-based aerosols now, very much. So these type of various things, even industrial pollution. There are two things in industrial pollution. One is automobile industry. Second thing is production or manufacturing or infrastructure engineering industries. Construction engineering is the worst thing. 900 kgs of carbon dioxide is produced from every 1000 kgs of cement. Nine recent survey, and we can make that 9 kgs of carbon dioxide is produced from every 10 kgs of cement. Now cement must be produced, and we have to contribute CO2 to the society, and by that we have to construct. The construction system is also expanding, multi-level constructions, poly-level constructions, insta constructions, infra constructions, ultra-level construction, innumerable things are happening. How? Without spoiling the nature, without exploiting nature, you cannot do that. It is unavoidable. So we have to abide by the nature, and we have to work out how practically these things occur also. And coming to also the section of biodiversity, it also affects the species. The major three affected areas are, one is the subhuman species. See, you must understand, you must not think that human being is doing everything. Even there is the meaning in the life of a worm. Even though not directly connected, it is doing something to its limited area. I have already told personal locus. And second thing is the advanced loci in the form of accessibility, ubiquity and permeability, I told. Like that, each and every species is the creation of God. Either it may be a worm, it may be a fly, they have a purpose. Certainly they have a purpose. And if something is eroded, immediately it has an impact. Either they have been created by nature or God for reduction of unwanted thing or induction of a natural cycle of process. Each and everything, there is a research article on this, how snakes are contributing to the world for human being. How rats are contributing, how parrots are contributing. Each and everything, they have some immediate locus with which they react. And that thing is reacting with the secondary one, that thing with the tertiary one, and it reaches ultimately to the human being for his benefit. So this thing is unavoidable. So extinction of lot of human beings, human race, and species race, even we consider as lot of other accidental, disastrous, and climate variations that naturally occurred, that has made lot of other para-human or pre-human species to be extinct, as per the genetic evolution theory. So now, extinction of lot of species. Now there is something known as fox fly. The fox fly is totally made extinct now. If the climate is differentiated from adaptable way of acclimatized way of survival, immediately those who are having the courage to live, they migrate. Those who cannot withstand, they die. Totally they are extinguished. They are becoming endangered, or either they are becoming extinct. Third thing is creating lot of opportunistic species. It is very important in symbiosis or in biodiversity. So whenever the nature creates something, the natural thing, either it demolishes its presence or it migrates to a conducive atmosphere. And the once more the dangerous revolution in the society is emergence of opportunity species. Now we are seeing dengue. We are just climbing with pride that we have demolished most of the diseases. Like we say that, yes, we have totally, we have uprooted plague, we have uprooted malaria. So we say we climb a lot of things. We are seeing the same thing come in a different disguise. We are seeing the same thing more decorative in a different brand. We are seeing new diseases. So these opportunistic species that are emerging in the society is nothing but different forms which give you alarm that something has come.